Hi guys, so today is a little kind of get ready with me tutorial, show and tell, what my favourites are, what I would repurchase kind of video. I'm going to do a separate video afterwards, but I thought I would just do a tutorial because I did actually do this last week, filmed it and everything, but as I was filming it, my camera just went, I've got no room left in my battery, whatever, storage, you know. And I was actually halfway through and it was like flashing at me saying, I've got no more room to store this video. And I was like, ah. So then I tried to delete some stuff and actually deleted a previous video that I'd filmed and it was just a disaster. So I'm gonna start filming again. I kind of emptied a lot out of my camcorder and I'm gonna hopefully, fingers crossed, get through this in one piece without interruptions or anything like that. So first of all, yes. I'm barefaced. I've kind of primed, moisturised. I haven't primed, I've moisturised and whatever. But the primer I'm going to use is the Evermatte Poreless Priming Protector by Becca. I picked this up recently in the US and it's a really nice mattifying primer. And I'm just going to put this on my areas that I'm going to need a little bit of help with the oils. Generally my forehead and the nose and the cheek area. I don't tend to get too oily in sort of this area. It's normally a bit drier, but it's just this area and kind of here and the nose. I generally have a little bit of oiliness. For foundation, I use my Rimmel Match Perfection. Love this stuff. Would normally put it on with a Real Techniques brush of some sort, like the Buffing or the Expert, but I'm going to use something different. And I've had this for a really, really long time. And recently, lots of people seem to be like going on and on about this product. And it's the Beauty Blender. And I had them for ages and just hadn't used them because brushes were just my go-to item. And I thought, I cleaned them up, they're all nice and wet and ready to go, and I thought I would just try it, and I'm gonna use it with my Rimmel and see what happens. It might be a disaster, I don't know, because I haven't used one of these in such a long time. I'm gonna put a bit on the back of my hand. I'm gonna get myself a mirror, and I'm just going to slap it on my face. So, but I haven't, like, I remember using this the first sort of time I got it, like, years ago, and I don't know if I knew how to use it properly or I don't know. I always feel with sponges that the product just gets sucked up and doesn't really end up on your face. But when everyone's like been going on YouTube and bloggers saying it's amazing, you need to try it, blah, blah, blah. I've kind of just been like, I need to try it again to see if I was just being an idiot and not using it correctly. But, yeah, we'll see what happens. You'll see the results in this video. But yeah, I'm just patting it on and whatnot all over my face. The Rimmel Match Perfection is actually quite a light foundation anyway. I think the sponge would be better with a thicker foundation. So we'll see. But I'm just patting it around and around my face. Like so. So that's that. It's kind of a light application, which I know a lot of people have said that the sponge gives, so I might end up putting a bit more on, I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, that is kind of that. I'm now going to start concealing under my eyes, and what I've been doing recently is a combo of like two things. I've been using this Age Rewind under eye eraser for dark circles, and I've been combining it with the Estee Lauder Double Wear concealer. I've been doing them both at the same time, and it's really kind of working out well because this is just a shade or two light for me, so it's kind of very lightening under the eye, so I wouldn't want to just use it on its own. But then when I put the Estee Lauder with it, it just warms it up a touch or two. So I'm just gonna put the Maybelline concealer corrector under my eyes. And as you can see, it's quite light and it just looks a little bit like ghostly. But then when I put the Estee Lauder Double Wear, it's kind of on the top of it. And then when I kind of buff into the skin, it just looks a little bit better. The brush I'm going to use to blend my concealer is this one, and it's from Sigma. It's one of those free ones you used to get when you used to order from them. And it's basically a 217 matte brush. And I'm just going to circular motions, blend this all into my under eye quite lightly. And I'm just trying not to screw up my face as well. Just be relaxed as possible so product doesn't get into any creases. But it's very, very nice that Maybelline Dark Circle Eraser, because it just brightens up the under eye area very nicely. And I've kind of just blended it all, and I'm just going to take my ring finger and just gently pat so it's set into the skin. So that is basically the face done. What I'm now going to do is going to powder, and I'm using the Bourjois Healthy Balance powder. This is kind of a mattifying powder. I'm just using a kabuki brush, and I'm just going to put this on my forehead, on my nose, not under my eyes. You'll see in a minute why. And I'm just putting it on my jawline and chin and cheeks, nose, whatnot, everywhere. So that. And then for the under eyes, I've been using this product that I love. I've talked about it before. It's the Secret Brightening Powder from Laura Mercier. And it's just a white powder, translucent powder. And I've been putting that on with the Real Techniques setting brush. And just a little bit popped onto the brush, tapped into the lid, kind of circular motions, getting it all on the brush. Then just patting it under the eyes. And it looks a bit scary because you put like white powder on the eyes, but it will literally just fall away and brush away when you've finished. But pat first, then once that area is kind of dry, then you can do like wiping motions to get rid of any excess, because you don't want to wipe straight away because you'll remove your concealer that you've just put on. So just pat first, then wipe. That's my little tip. For cheeks, the colour I've been loving on my cheeks is my Love Struck Rose Bourjois. I actually just use the brush that it comes with. It's just such a cute little brush, and it, where the shape of the brush just puts it perfectly on your cheeks. It's just really, really pretty. And it's just like a little flush of pinky coral, and it's just perfect. It's not too much, it's not too shimmery, it's not too pink, it's not too coral. Just that perfect kind of colour for your face. So that's that. I'm now going to put on a bit of bronzer, and the one I'm going to use is my warm bronzer from e.l.f. I absolutely love this, and I use that brush I used for the powder, and I just do this with the side of the brush, not in like that, just sideways kind of sweeping. And what I do, I just put it here, just kind of draw like a T, almost like a line there and a line there, and then just kind of buff it into that area. But that's kind of just where I put my bronzer. I don't try and put it anywhere else, just up and down like that and across, and then just buff. I do, like, if I have anything left, I'll just put it on my nose, on my forehead, and maybe a bit on the chin, but I just generally keep it here, so like a free shape or a T if you want to, I don't know. But yeah, that's generally what I do. For the eyes, I use my Nubile Paint Pot by MAC. I always use this. You probably knew I was going to use this before I even mentioned it. So I'm put that onto my lids. Like that. It's just a nude cream colour base. It's beautiful and just, yes, I love it. It's a shame it was limited edition, but you know. What are you going to do? For shadows, I'm going to use my Naked 2 palette. And I'm going to, first of all, I'm going to put a bit of a crease in. And I'm going to, if I can find a brush, I'm just going to use the brush actually in here. I'm going to use the Tease colour, which is this kind of dirty mauve brown colour. I'm just going to put that into the crease to just define the crease. A little bit. Gives a bit of shadowing and depth to the eye. I'm not going to bring it all the way in, just sort of here and down.
That's all I'm doing. And then I'm going to take this shadow that I picked up in America. I don't know if you can get it here, but you can get one similar, and it's the L'Oreal Infallible shadow, and it is in the shade Amber Rush, which is such a pretty golden ambery colour. It's very pretty. I'll show you. Looks like this. It's very, very light reflecting. I'm just going to pop that on with a 217 matte brush, and I'm just going to swirl my colour in to pick some up, and I'm just going to pop that to the inner corner and out towards the edge. Not all the way, because we're just going to put another colour in to smoke it out and make it smoky eye. I'm just patting that amber rush in the inner and the middle, not too far on the outer area. Like that. Then I'm going to go back with that Urban Decay brush, and I'm going to take the blackout colour, which is the black, and I'm going to pat that gently on the end like that, and I'm just going to tap off, and I'm just going to pop a little bit on the outer corner and kind of just bring it across gently. You could even use your fingers if you wanted, but I'm just kind of buffing it across very lightly to give a bit of depth. But you can just pat it, almost stippling motions if you wanted, and then just pull it across very lightly. And you can just build up the colour if you want, the intensity, and then you can just take the same matte brush and just blend those two colours together. Nothing on there, just the excess stuff that was on there from the other shadow. I say excess stuff, I mean excess shadow, sorry. Just kind of blend it so it looks a little bit smoky. Now for eyeliner, I love liquid eyeliner. I find it's the easiest liner to put on. I just throw everything everywhere. The one I'm using, or have been using and loving forever, is the L'Oreal Superliner. It's very black, very shiny. It just looks like a lacquer. It's just very, very nice. I love the applicator as well. It's just so easy to just kind of make a line. Even if you're a newbie at it, it's just, you can create a thick line, light, like a little line. It's just so easy, and I've done it in like, how many seconds was that? As I was talking to you, it's just so easy. And you can create little flicks. And then, yeah, it's just so easy to use. Absolutely love it. And that's that. How many seconds did that take me? Anyway, so that is the eyeliner done. I'm now going to do my mascara. And the mascara I'm going to use is my Falsies by Maybelline. But first of all, I'm going to curl my lashes. And using the ones I got in my Birchbox, just to quickly curl them. I'm going to use two different versions of the Falsies mascara. I'm going to use the normal one, which isn't waterproof. I'm going to use the Black Drama one. Then I'm going to use a waterproof version on top, just to seal it in so I don't end up getting panda eyes if it starts to rain or I get a watery eye. So this is the Black Drama one. I'm just going to pop that on. I'm just going to do the upper lashes only. I'm not going to do the bottom ones. Just apply it like this all over your lashes. I try and just wiggle it and work mascara from the bottom, like the base, and all the way to the tip. And sometimes I just go on the top and just gently apply it to the top of the lashes, because generally you just go like that, but it's good to try and get on top as well. It looks great already. I love the brush with this. So just apply it. Give it a wiggle. Just make sure you get all your lashes. Make sure the inner ones are all caught as well. that. Then I'm going to take the waterproof version and just go over the top just to seal it in. You're probably thinking, why didn't you just use the waterproof? Sometimes I think using waterproof on its own, I think it's harder to remove in the evenings when you want to take your makeup off. If you put like a normal mascara on top first, then the waterproof, I find it just slips off a little bit easier. It's not just so welded on to the lashes. That's my opinion. If, you know, that's what I like to do, works for me, so you might want to try it. I do not know, but yeah, that's, I just like to layer my mascaras at the moment. It just seems to work well for me. And it just, they look false. I love the whole false look without having to put actual false mascara, false lashes on. So just apply that to all the lashes. Like that. For eyebrows, I don't really do much to my eyebrows. I generally just leave them. I'm gonna be honest. I just make sure they're all kind of facing the right direction. I don't generally fill them in during the week. I'm a bit lazy like that. I just think they look okay. If you think differently, then I'm sorry. But yeah, I don't really do much to my eyebrows. But for my lips, I've been loving the Revlon Kissable Balm Stain Crayons, whatever you want to call them. I'm going to use Rendezvous, which is this corally red colour. It's really gorgeous. It just adds a little pop to the lips. Like so. And it's really easy to apply. You could even do it without a mirror and it lasts for ages on the lips. It's just stains them, looks very, very nice, and they don't dry out or anything like that, and they're really, really nice and affordable. So yeah, that is kind of my makeup, what I've been wearing at the moment kind of video. I hope you liked it. I'm going to do a little bit of an in-depth talk about some of the products I've used in another video, which I'll link up here when it's available on YouTube for you to see. But yeah, I hope you have a great day and I'll see you soon.